Electronics and Communication Engineering Department is born out of Electrical Department. So that way Electrical Department is a parent for us. And Electrical Department was mainly focused on power generation, power transmission. But later there was extensive progress that has taken place in the communication domain, where you talk of transmitting signal from one place to the other place. And so it was necessary for us to create a new department which focuses more on data transmission, how securely you can transmit data. So with that, we have created the Department of Electronics and Communication in the year 1971.
Our department has a very good placement ratio, like most of like about 80% to 90% of our students get placed. And our faculty is very well trained, and we have equipment, like you can see the lab. This is the power electronics lab, and our equipment is like cutting edge and it's good.
So if I have to quote one of my students, so he said that the Electronics and Communication Engineering Department stands apart because they offer plenty of electives and which are relevant to today's world. And we have 8 electives being offered.
The professors are very helpful, and if you want to like do research under some professor and write papers, because a lot of people want to go abroad for doing the MS in US colleges or you know colleges in Europe, and for that you need to have a very strong profile. Now what Manipal does for this is like they have there's this thing called the MUSRF, or the Manipal University Student Research Forum. So any professor who's doing a project, or like you know any student who's doing a project, their names are listed in the MUSRF. And if you're interested in doing a project or collaborating with a professor, you can choose to do so. The core companies which come for ECE are like Qualcomm, then there's Cisco, then Honeywell, Siemens, then Schneider, General Electric, GE Healthcare, a lot of companies.
My present students ask me, sir, there is computer science, and there is electronics and communication engineering. And when we go to the placement, it is the computer science department that gets filled first. So can you tell me, why should I join your department? Yeah, I tell them that, see, electronics and communication engineering department, that is the one which has a wider breadth. So if you want to keep your options wide open, then you have to be in electronics. So with electronics and communication engineering, you can do a specialization in computer science. You can also do specialization in, say, embedded system, VLSI, like that. Your options are open. Our students have risen to the level of CEOs of Microsoft in the form of Satya Nadella and Rajiv Suri taking care of Nokia. So that way, department has created global leaders. Your hardship doesn't end at the end of 4 years. Your hardship begins at the end of 4 years. The outside society is much more harsher than what we are. And we are preparing you for that. So you are going to be the global leaders. So you cannot run away from problems. You need to solve problems.